Hello and welcome to the agenda. I am Ajay Kaul. Today we will discuss about the state of our economy. India's economy, which saw unprecedented dip in the earlier part of this year, is recovering now according to the government projections. The country's GDP had recorded the historic low of -23.9% in the April-June quarter of this year, mainly due to the lockdown imposed because of coronavirus. However, according to the government and the RBI, ever since the unlock started, the economy has been gathering pace and is projected to keep improving to turn positive by the end of the current financial year. So, how hopeful should we be? We will try to understand this in the agenda today with two experts on economy. We have with us Mr. Abhishek Rajaram and Mr. Akash Jindal. But before we begin our conversation, let's have a look at this small report.
India's GDP showed contraction of 7.5% in the July-September quarter this year, against 4.4% growth in the same quarter of last financial year, according to the government data. In the April-June quarter of this financial year, the country's GDP had recorded the historic low of -23.9%, mainly due to the lockdown imposed because of coronavirus. The government and the RBI are confident that the economy would recover from the impact of lockdown fast and that it would turn positive in the third quarter of the current financial year. A number of indicators are being cited as a reason for optimism. These include the highest GST collection of over rupees 1 lakh crore in September, increase in auto sales and rise in services sector activity. The government also says that the demand is increasing, mainly driven by domestic consumption. The recovery from the lockdown has been stronger than expected, according to RBI Governor Shaktikant Das. One of the sectors which remain the bright spot even during the lockdown is agriculture. The sector remained green with the help of good monsoon and subsidized inputs. However, sectors like manufacturing remain dull and the state of unorganized sector continues to be in shambles. The government data show that output of 8 sectors dropped by 2.5% in October. In this situation, it is to be seen how soon the country will return on the path of positive growth. Bureau report.
Let's welcome our guests Abhishek Rajaram and Akash Jindal. Welcome to the program. My first question is to Mr. Rajaram. The government and RBI are saying that the economy is improving fast. What is your view, initial view?
India is a democratic country. You can say anything. So, MPC policy says that we have to work on, we will give details and every we will give details. The report was quarterly. Why they are delaying it? Regarding the GST, GST was planned with 14% growth. It was committed in GST compensation cess also. And now they are agreeing that, okay, 6% growth is okay with it and for the balance you can take loan. If the economy is so good, then why RBI is saying that we will end up in we will end up with negative numbers for this year? So, and finance minister can, while announcing Atmanirbhar Bharat Package 3,
but I think RBI is saying that we will be positive by the turn, I mean third quarter onwards.
No, they are saying that for the fourth quarter we would be positive, but we will end the year with negative numbers.
Yeah, overall. Today
evening the numbers will come. Don't worry, the numbers would not be very good. They would be in double-digit contradiction. That's my view.
Okay, Mr. Akash Jindal, I want to ask you the same question. How are you foreseeing the economy, India's economy? Is it recovering?
I think yes, the economy for sure is recovering. See, now if we look at numbers, we have got numbers now. One is GST collection. GST collection last year, 1,05,000 crore. I think that's a okay number. But apart from that, manufacturing and manufacturing, the numbers are good. Purchase and consumption, and again, employment activities have also increased. I think the economy is definitely on recovery, can't happen, but if on the track to recover, we shouldn't anyway undermine India's buying power, India's consumption, India's middle class power. I've been saying it earlier also on Indian and Google that India is resilient. We have the ability to bounce back much faster than other economies. Another one, also we all know, was it a thing where government had to impose a lock for some amount of recovery has happened. I think growth, the basic recovery should be coming in Q3, the current quarter which we are in. So now, one, because of pre-Diwali, secondly, post-Diwali, a huge North Indian called Saha, in a huge demand generation. So this is the quarter to be a good quarter for us. The negativity would end Q4, February to March quarter. I think a good quarter for us.
But Mr. Jindal, you, so, Mr. Jindal, you, yeah, please, yeah, carry on.
See, we can't recover fully, but we are on the recovery path.
Right.
We are slowly on the recovery path. We have to see how fast we can recover, how fast we can grow. That many things, the government's initiative, all the comes, all depend on that. But we are definite on the track, on path to recovery.
Right, we are on the recovery path and we have the resilience to recover. But as you mentioned, GST figures were actually the accumulated figures of last year, isn't it?
Yeah, I just repeat.
I'm saying the GST figures were 1,05,000 crore because of the accumulated. They were accumulated over a period. Last year also they were accumulated and it was a summation of. That is why the figures were high. GST recovery, so revenues. GST,
one of the figures, I focus on GST. Focus mainly is on the two-wheeler. We see the figure and four production number. Now, why manufacturers so much as far as cars and two-wheelers is concerned? Because they can sense demand in the market. Because there is a demand in the market. So because there is a demand in the market and there is recovery, when there is so economy is showing so signs of recovery. Now, if you talk about construction and real estate, construction and real estate have also resumed. And people have given a royal ignore. Royal ignore is the real estate market. Now, people get stuck at, but those I talk to them and ask them about the real estate market. Now, it would be very surprised for certain people to know that real estate price up for. Rather, in the economy calls are what is lockdown, real estate, certain pockets.
Mr. Jindal, I think Mr. Raja
in other India. So, yeah. So clearly, so that is there, demand is there, and somewhere latent, the under recovery is there. Now, what I'm suggesting is if the government is the stimulus right now. The government did the stimulus earlier, at the time our economy was down. Now,
this would okay, Mr. Jindal. Mr. Jindal, I think Mr. Rajaram wants to say something. I think he seems to be kind of differing from your view. Mr. Rajaram, please.
My dear fellow citizens, and my dear fellow Akash Jindal ji, the economist. I ask a simple question: why the Section 16 of Section 4 has been brought in the GST regime? Why 36.4 has been installed? Why ITC is available as per 2A, 2B? Why you are coming with QRMP schemes from 1st of Jan? Is this the GST number? Don't pump up GST numbers. They are all sham. You are indulging in the late fees penalties in the name of GST. Give me the breakup of GST with the taxes penalties, late fees and interest, and you will come to know GST collection is not up to the mark. And regarding the numbers, for the October month, consumer price index is 7.61% and CFPI is 11.07%. This is a report of this month published by Ministry of Fiscal and Planning and Implementation. Now, is the GST collection a rose at that level? No. Industries are not working. Don't come with GST numbers. Don't say that GST numbers are good. Don't say. With the late fees, this GST number, 1,05,000 crore, has sweat and blood of traders of MSMEs, which includes late fees penalties. Yesterday itself, lakhs of notices has been issued by GSTIN saying that your return has not been filed for October month in Delhi itself, because the date was extended to 24/20 as a due date. Now, what kind of digital India you are making? What GST portal is doing? Why such notices are coming? Why penalties? And everything you come with, if that is now come with 14% growth rate, and tell me why the 14% growth rate has not been achieved in GST? Why states have been forced to take a loan from RBI? Don't say GST numbers. You don't understand GST numbers. Don't fight on GST. Why September due date has not been extended because of Corona? February to August due date has been extended. Every day you come with high level fraud to see that 1,000 crore was hacking of fake IT, 1,000 crore, 5,000 crore, 800 crore. You came with a figure of 7,800 crore on GST and you arrested him. In last 3.5 have to get a single person punished by the court. Have to be able to prove the numbers in court. No, just management, just saying GST is not going to help you.
Okay, Mr. Rajaram, I think
itself has been...
Okay, Mr. Rajaram, I think Mr. Jindal wants to say something on that.
Now, my dear friend spoke in a complicated manner as far as GST. Now, I'm not the friend who would answer all the provisions GST. Now, but to talk about economy, I pointed out, last thing which I pointed was, now I can name where post-COVID, the real prices are higher than that pre-COVID times. At January, February, if a flat or plot was available, 50, now it is 50 or it is sold. It is not only 55 or 54 lakhs. But in this, the prices are higher than that period. It means appetite is there, money is there, number of housing loan inquiries.
Mr. Jindal, appetite may be there, but there is no liquid available with people.
That's what I'm saying, sir. Allow me to.
I think we. Yeah.
It's a very. They have asked. Appetite is there. I also have me. Prices which I am telling you. Those prices at which. Now, if you want any sub-registrar of any city and take pockets of it, the amount of actually happening, then the micro companies, all of them have got real estate at construction. There are certain developers, their labor back from their own pockets. They haven't wanted it. It tells about the appetite of the buyer. Cars and two cars are the luxury. Why would people go ask if so much of the pressure in the economy? I don't people buying new cars. The conventional theme would ask them to use on using the whatever the shape, but the sort of car the sort of.
Okay, Mr. Jindal, I'll ask Mr. Rajaram. Mr. Rajaram, as he, you heard Mr. Jindal is citing the car sales and auto sales have gone up, two-wheeler, car, etc. So he is saying that is an indicative of recovery of economy. What do you say on that?
Of course, that is an indicative of purchasing cars and two-wheelers are part of that because of social distancing, traffic, one put in the in public transport. Second thing, when he's talking about the industry, let's discuss about production also. Manufacture motor vehicles has been only 84% of what was in last year for September 2020.
But I'll point out that auto sales, I think, has witnessed 10% increase over year or not.
I'm coming to that. Yeah. Because there was no sale between the last week of March and the lockdown till July, when the lockdown was effectively opened. So in last three, four months, there was absolute no sale. So that's why the sale numbers were going to increase. Second, due to COVID, one wants to travel in his own vehicle. That's why also sales is increasing. But coming back to whether other sales are increasing or not, whether we are going to get something or not, the only thing is minings are around 83%, which was of last year. When you talk about the general index of manufacturing data, industrial production, that is negative 7.8% for September. So industries are not performing. Electricity consumption has also reduced. Also, let me explain you one single thing vis-a-vis number. So, for example, 2019-20, our GDP is 100. For a safer side, take it as 100. And for the first year, we are that it will be negative by minus 10.3. So by end of 2021, the economy would be 89.7. And if we get 8.8% growth also, so if we add 8.8% here, it comes to 97.59. So by March 2022, our economy would not be at that level, which was in March 20. So we are into recession.
Mr. Rajaram, that was expected because of
government action are very slow. Last line.
Yeah.
Government actions are very slow because Kamath Committee recommended providing benefits to 26 sectors, vis-a-vis the government provided only to 8 sectors. And last week only they said, okay, we will be covering 26 sectors. So they are not even listening to bureaucracy, but they are guiding or they are recommending them. So had the government accepted whole of the recommendation and provided this, economy would have flourished for us.
Okay, Mr. Jindal wants to say something. Yeah, please.
See, one thing we have to understand, one thing needs to be driven home very clearly is, we can't keep on comparing us with the last year figures. We all know that this is COVID era. So now we are talking, and I think Kalsa would endorse me, is how good the recovery is. We are not at all saying that we are better off than the last year or 2 years prior to this. Whatever the data was, our data is better. What we are saying, all of us know, all of us understand and acknowledge that COVID was a huge economic issue globally for the entire world. Now the entire global GDP is expected to be minus 4.5% for the coming 1 year. So one thing is very much clear. That recession was there because of COVID. It was an unexpected thing which happened to economy. Now, I think Kalsa would endorse what we are discussing it. How well are we recovering?
Right.
Whether we are recovering or not. Whether we are sinking deeper or are we recovering. There I am saying that recovery is there. The point which I am trying to drive home is that April to June quarter was bad because of unexpected COVID and lockdown hitting us. After that, Q2 of this financial year is expected to be better than the first one, and Q3 is definitely better. So the point which I want to drive home is that we are definitely on the recovery path. I have never said that we have fully recovered, but signs of recovery are there. Government's efforts, I would hear, praise Prime Minister Modi, he has put in great effort. The package he had given to the economy, that package has also started yielding results. Similarly, corporate sector also, it's back on the track. Hiring has restarted. Hiring has restarted at all levels. Manufacturing has increased. IIT and purchase managers index, that also shows that. Plus, jobs are there in the lower fields also. For our labor brothers also, there are quite numbers of jobs, and there have been cases where the labor has been fetched from the villages to the cities to work. Data also, things are being exhibited in the data as far as
housing transactions is concerned, real estate prices are concerned, vehicle sales are concerned. So we are on recovery path. Now, if we keep on being pessimistic about our own country, I don't think we are going to reach anywhere.
Right.
Now, particularly the main thing, please allow me 10 more seconds. The main thing right now we have to do is we have to believe in our economy, believe in our country, and be optimistic. And COVID is such a time, psychologically, we don't have to be pessimistic. If we psychologically get into pessimism, then I don't think we'll reach anywhere. A person who is into depression or pessimism can't get himself or economy anywhere. We have to be optimistic. Things are looking good. Data is better. Government is putting effort. Corporates are putting effort. Things are reflecting in the, numbers. Going ahead, the numbers are expected to be better. So what I feel is firmly that April 2021, we'll be back on the same numbers. So we are on the path to recovery. I think
how can that be back on the same numbers? How can that be back on the same numbers? How can that be back on the same numbers? How can April 21 be
held? There are certain other things also which the government needs to do.
How,
I think the government
Okay, Mr. Rajaram, let him complete and then you can say.
I think now we are in a position where if we give in a stimulus package right now, which we are expecting also from the government, that can work wonders for the economy.
Okay.
But we have to believe in our country, believe in ourselves.
Right, we have to
believe in our economy.
Right.
This belief is not going to lead us anywhere. That's right. What I firmly believe.
Right, we have to believe in our country and ourselves. And I think Rajaram has some point to make.
Sir, we have seen, 2 minutes, in middle class, even the child comes with 50% mark, then parent scold for her, saying that your potential is of 99%. You come with 90%. But though it is 90%, I am not happy. Same is with us all. India, any growth rate below 6% looks like a slowdown. And when it is negative number, recession impacts. The only thing is, with this recovery, I have explained you what the World Bank has said, -6% and 8.8%. What I am saying, with this recovery rate, we would end up in reset in 2020. That's why, because today's effort will take us out of the recession and bring us back to the path of growth. We all want India to grow further. That's why, and if we are criticizing government, that doesn't mean that we are into pessimistic mode.
Right.
A person can criticize the government and with number, with facts. I have always struggled with the number. I have been discussing these are the pointers, these are the numbers, and I have taken all the data from ministry information only, and these are official data. And second thing, with regard to hiring, salary cut is reality. Today we are seeing many people have got salary cut. Second, pink slips are also very much prevalent today. Aatmanirbhar package, has a dispute on Aatmanirbhar Pact whether it was a 20 lakh or effectively it was a 1 or 2% budget. Third thing, in Aatmanirbhar Pact they have covered the TDS refund. So maybe if your tax has been deducted extra, then you are generally allowed to take your refund. And that has also been added, or reduction of TDS has also been added in the Aatmanirbhar Bharat package. So that is not the correct method. That is not the correct way. One who is criticizing government is not a terrorist, is not pessimistic mode. My dear friend, please do understand. We can have genuine concerns also. For GST, we have a genuine concern for income tax refund. Now they have refunded, in last 3 months, they have refunded more than 1 lakh crore rupees, which was pending for last 6 years. So if this amount was pending for individual for last 6 years, then with who is responsible? And if we don't ask question in the Modi government, and if we don't with Modi ji as a prime minister, then with whom we should go and ask for recovery? Do tell me other leader name. I will accept your claim that I am wrong. Is there any leader whom we can trust more than Modi ji? Do you have any name?
Right, Mr. Jindal Ali, Rajaram has a point that if there are some wrong is happening or something right is not happening, one can criticize always, isn't it?
Now I have a point. which is clear-cut counter to my good friend. Stock market Sensex is at a whole-time high, all-time high. Now, Indian stock market is a market where the entire world invests.
But Mr. Jindal, you will also acknowledge that Sensex does not reflect the real economy of the country.
No, I am not saying that. Including biggest of institutions, biggest of pension funds, biggest of mutual funds throughout the world, would they not choose any other country? Because here it's not only domestic investors. Here there are investors, global investors, who would have selected India against China, who are investing here. Now those are global research houses. The stock market is at the all-time high. I am not saying the data is better. It's at all-time high. I am not at all certifying that it is a reflector of the economy, but there would be some strength in the economy. Why global investors are invested? Global investors right. are hard-headed people.
So you are talking about the sentiment.
They manage money of so many investors whom they are answerable to.
So you are
not only that, the other things which I have told you that show that the economy is recovering. See, we all understand and we have to acknowledge that.
Okay, Mr. Jindal, we got your point. We are running out of time. Last comment, I think Mr. Rajaram wants to make. Mr. Rajaram, he says that sentiment, Sensex, while he is referring to, it's reflected to sentiment.
Yeah. Sensex was all-time high when we saw Shining India movement and somebody fought election also in 2004. Sensex doesn't mean anything, not everything, at least.
No, he says because it is a sentiment of investors. There are two things.
First, volumes are not as equivalent as were in February or January 2020. With lesser volumes, the movement are higher. Second thing, the average PE of 50-50 is 22 to 25, which is a good range. Currently, the PE is above 35, which it will say says that market is at high level and a correction is bound to happen. When it will happen, that would be very bad. And those who are claiming Sensex is something, when the market will crash, or when the bubble will be bust. Bubble is always when it is bust.
Okay, Mr. Raja, we are run out of time, but we hope that the bubble doesn't burst and our economy improves and keeps improving. But thank you both of you for participating in this debate. This is all in the agenda today. Thanks for watching. I'll be back with another important topic tomorrow. Till then, goodbye.